A calcified granuloma in the lungs may sound alarming, but it's often a benign indication of the body's past battle with an infection. As our body's defense mechanisms work to isolate and contain foreign invaders, granulomas form. Over time, these can accumulate calcium deposits, making them visible on medical imaging. We created this video to cover the medical definition and provide a brief overview of this topic. So, if you're ready, let's get into it. As previously mentioned, a calcified granuloma in the lungs is a small, benign nodule that forms as a result of the body's attempt to isolate and contain an old infection or foreign substance. Over time, calcium deposits can accumulate within the granuloma, making it visible on an X-ray. Calcified granulomas in the lungs are primarily caused by infections or immune responses to foreign substances. Infections that can trigger granuloma formations include tuberculosis caused by Mycobacterium tuberculosis bacterium and fungal infections such as histoplasmosis or coccidioidomycosis. These infections often result in the body's immune cells clustering to form nodules within the lung tissue. In addition to infections, inflammatory conditions and autoimmune diseases can also lead to the development of granulomas. The symptoms of calcified lung granulomas can vary and may be mild or absent in some cases. Individuals with lung granuloma may experience a cough which can be either dry or productive. In some cases, the cough might become chronic and persist for a long time. Patients may also report shortness of breath and difficulty in performing routine activities. Wheezing is another symptom that can be observed in some individuals, especially when the granuloma obstructs the airways. Chest pain is another possible symptom, which can range from mild discomfort to severe, depending on the location and size of the granuloma. Infections such as histoplasmosis can cause additional symptoms like fever and general malaise. When lung granulomas progress or are left untreated, complications could arise. One such complication is the development of fibrosis, which is the thickening and scarring of lung tissue. In severe cases, extensive fibrosis can lead to a condition called pulmonary fibrosis, in which the lungs lose their ability to efficiently exchange oxygen and carbon dioxide. This can lead to respiratory failure and other serious health problems. Diagnosing calcified granulomas in the lungs typically involves a combination of imaging tests and clinical evaluation. The first step in the diagnostic process is often a chest X-ray. Calcified granulomas may appear in the chest X-ray as small, dense areas, which are more easily seen due to the calcium deposits within the lesion. However, the appearance of granulomas on the X-ray can sometimes resemble other conditions, such as lung nodules or even malignancies. To obtain a clearer and more precise image of the lung tissue, doctors may recommend CT scans. These imaging tests provide greater detail than X-rays and allow for a more confident diagnosis of calcified granulomas. CT scans can better differentiate between benign granulomas and other lung abnormalities. In some cases, a biopsy may be necessary to confirm the diagnosis and rule out other conditions such as lung cancer. A variety of techniques can be used to obtain lung tissue samples, including bronchoscopy, in which a flexible tube with a light and camera is inserted through the patient's airways to visualize the lung tissue. During the bronchoscopy procedure, the doctor may take samples of the suspected granuloma for further analysis. Once all the relevant tests have been performed and a thorough clinical evaluation has been conducted, the doctors will make a diagnosis and discuss the results with the patient. Although calcified granulomas are generally benign and often asymptomatic, it is essential to properly diagnose these lung lesions and differentiate them from more serious conditions such as malignancies or infections to ensure appropriate treatment and follow-up care. In most cases, calcified granulomas in the lungs do not require treatment since they often form as a result of the body's immune response to infection, and the calcification indicates that the granuloma is no longer active. However, when symptoms or complications arise, various treatment options may be considered. Medications are usually the first line of treatment for symptomatic granulomas or those caused by persistent infection. The specific medication prescribed will depend on the underlying cause of the granuloma. For instance, If it's caused by a bacterial infection, antibiotics are typically prescribed to eliminate the infection. Alternatively, if a fungal infection is the culprit, an antifungal medication is recommended. In cases where granulomas result from an inflammatory condition, such as sarcoidosis, the use of corticosteroids is common to help reduce inflammation. These drugs can be prescribed for both oral and inhaled use, depending on the severity and location of the inflammation. Surgery is typically reserved for severe cases or situations where granulomas cause significant complications, such as obstructing airways or leading to the formation of lung abscesses. The surgical remover of granulomas may be performed to alleviate symptoms, prevent complications, and improve overall lung function. The outlook for individuals with these granulomas is generally favorable, as they often indicate a healing process in response to inflammation or infection. Prevention of calcified granuloma in the lungs focuses on maintaining good overall health and avoiding factors that can cause inflammation or infection. Some steps to help prevent granulomas include practicing good hygiene, such as regular hand washing to reduce the risk of infections, maintaining a healthy lifestyle by eating a balanced diet, exercising regularly, and avoiding smoking or exposure to secondhand smoke, and seeking prompt medical attention for respiratory symptoms, especially those that persist or worsen over time. While there's no specific treatment for calcified granulomas, addressing any underlying inflammation or infection can help alleviate symptoms and prevent further complications. Regular checkups with your healthcare provider are essential, as they can monitor your lung health and recommend appropriate interventions if necessary. If you want to support the channel, please like and subscribe. I would greatly appreciate it. And there should be some other helpful videos popping up on your screen right about now that I think you'll enjoy. And just a quick reminder, we're not doctors. This video is for informational purposes only. Thank you so much for watching. Have a blessed day, and as always, breathe easy, my friend.